There are four screens in the review module: Review Profile, Review Authorization, Other Auths and Pre-Audits, and Sign and Submit. You can access all four of these screens at any time by selecting them on the progress bar. However, before DTS will let you sign a document, you must access these screens in the order listed. When you select Review Profile on the progress bar, the Review Profile screen displays your personal contact information and account data as listed in your DTS personal profile. If you need to change any information in your DTS personal profile, select Open Profile. To update your profile, select a category from the left column and complete the fields in the right column before you save. If the change should apply to all future documents you create, check the box next to Update Permanent Profile before you select Save. If you don't check that box, your changes will apply to the current document only. To check whether a DTS document contains your current profile information, open the document in a View Only mode. In View Only modes, a Compare Profiles button replaces the Save button. Select it to see a side-by-side comparison of the profile information in the document and the profile information in your DTS profile. In this example, we can see that the last name in the document is different than in the DTS profile. Once you've finished verifying and/or modifying the profile information, select Continue. The Review Authorization section is an overview of your entire document. You should verify all the information is correct before continuing at the bottom. If any information is incorrect, navigate to that module by selecting it on the navigation or progress bar, or selecting the Go To link. The Other Auths and Pre-Audits page is made up of three different sections. Other authorizations are statements that must appear on your printed travel order. DTS adds some and provides comments for them based on your choices you made elsewhere in the authorization. Other authorizations that were added by DTS cannot be removed except by changing the selection that caused the other authorization to appear. You can add other comments or remove them as needed. Every other authorization requires a comment. If DTS did not provide one, you must add it. To add an other authorization, select Add Other Authorization. Pre-audit flags are items flagged for exceeding established cost thresholds, or things that break travel policy without specific AO approval. You must provide a justification for each flagged item to explain why you selected it and why the AO should approve it. If your justification is insufficient, the AO will return the document to you for correction or for further explanation. Some flagged items will require reason codes in addition to the justification. Pre-audit advisories do not require justifications, but instead will alert you to items of potential concern or remind you about something you may have forgotten. Pre-audit flags are designed to assist you in following with DoD travel policy, so it's always a good idea to try to have as few of them as possible. In this example, the traveler erroneously claimed lodging twice. Lodging is always claimed under the lodging portion of per diem, but sometimes travelers add it as an other expense. If the AO catches this and sends it back to the traveler to fix, it can cause delays in processing the document. If the AO does not catch this and approves it as is, and a subsequent voucher is filed, the traveler will be overpaid and will owe money back to the government. Pre-audit flags may be confusing, so be sure to refer to Appendix K of the DTA manual for information if you're unsure of what caused the pre-audit flag and what kind of justification may be required. If the condition that causes a pre-audit flag is removed, the pre-audit flag will be removed as well. Once all the other authorizations and pre-audit justifications have been accounted for, select Continue. The digital signature page displays important information about the document's history and future in a chronological order. Any previous status stamps will be included near the top along with the current status stamp. In this example, the document is in a created status. The document requires a signed stamp before the routing process can begin. Depending on the type of user and status of the document, this will vary. In order to apply the sign stamp, you will need to check this box. Ensure you select the correct routing list. Follow your local guidance to determine the correct routing list to use. Any comments to the routing officials can be added to the document by selecting Add Comments. Ensure you read the comments about your document before selecting Submit Completed Document, as this action will legally sign it to be submitted for routing and approval. If the document is already routing, the next required steps will be displayed below the current status. In this example, the document is not routing, so the next steps will not be determined until a routing list is selected and the document is submitted. The document was successfully submitted, so now the current status is CTO Submit. Continue to monitor the document to ensure the document updates to CTO Booked within one business day. If it does not update, please contact the Travel Assistance Center for assistance. Signing the authorization begins the routing process. If your routing list contains the reviewed step, then this step occurs after the TMC action. But eventually your authorization goes to the AO for approval, then your supporting financial institution for monetary processing. Your pre-trip responsibilities do not end with your signature. You should always confirm ticketing by the TMC for your air travel before you head to the airport. There are a number of options to confirm your ticketing status, ensuring you are ready to travel. Log into DTS and navigate to the digital signature screen. If the CTO ticketed stamp appears in your document history, the TMC has ticketed your trip. Check your email. Most TMCs send you an email when they ticket your flights, which happens about 3 business days before your trip starts. Go online to your TMC's website. After you enter some identifying information about your trip, you'll see your ticketing status. Call the TMC. Please be aware that contacting your TMC may result in a TMC fee. For more information, please visit the Defense Travel Management Office website. You can also check out Appendix K of the DTA Manual and the DTS Guide Chapter 2 for authorizations. For more videos like this one, Be sure to subscribe below.